Assalamu alaikum. 1 p.m. This is Radio Pakistan. The news read by Maqsoodur Rahman. First, the headlines. UNHCR will suspend the repatriation process of Afghan refugees in Pakistan for around 3 months due to cold weather from 1st of next month. Renowned analysts have said Indian involvement in Afghanistan's affairs could be a threat to stability of Pakistan. Commemorations are underway around the globe to mark the centenary of armistice that ended World War I. The third one-day international between Pakistan and New Zealand will be played in Dubai today. And now the news in detail. The United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees has decided to suspend the repatriation process of Afghan refugees in Pakistan from 1st of next month for around 3 months due to cold weather. According to a spokesperson of the UNHCR, the repatriation process will be halted from 1st of next month till 28th of February next year due to drop in temperature and severe cold. He said all UNHCR centers in Pakistan and Afghanistan will remain closed during the winter. Registered Afghan refugees will not be given financial compensation in case of return during the period. The operation will resume after winter season. Renowned analysts have called for allaying Pakistan's reservations regarding Indian involvement in Afghanistan's affairs. Talking to News and Current Affairs of Radio Pakistan, they said the Indian involvement in Afghan affairs could be a threat to stability of Pakistan. The analysts said Pakistan and Afghanistan need joint strategy and closer cooperation to address the root cause of terrorism. Advisor to Prime Minister on Climate Change, Malik Amin Aslam Khan, has urged the world to take steps for climate change mitigation. He was speaking at the Climate Media Dialogue organized by Embassy of Poland in Islamabad. The advisor said the Intergovernmental Panel of Climate Change Report 2018 is alarming, which calls for measures to control climate change. By-election for two seats of Senate from Punjab, including a general and a reserved seat for women, will be held on Thursday. These seats had fallen vacant due to denotification of Haroon Khan and Sadia Abbasi as senators in light of a Supreme Court verdict. 54 suspects were arrested during search operations in different areas of Kuwait this morning, according to Kuwait police. Arms and ammunition were also recovered from them. Pakistan has made an enhanced contribution to the UN agency entrusted to assist Palestinian refugees. Pakistan's permanent representative to the United Nations, Maliha Lodhi, handed over the enhanced contribution to Director UN Relief and Works Agency in New York. The UN agency ran into deep financial trouble earlier this year when the United States cut back its funding of the agency by around $300 million. Speaking on the occasion, Maliha Lodhi said, "The people of Pakistan have always stood with their Palestinian brothers and sisters." BJP-led Indian government has tasked its National Investigation Agency to arrest Kashmiri students studying in different states of the country on false charges and portray the Kashmiri's legitimate struggle for right to self-determination as terrorism. In a latest such bid, the Indian authorities have handed over the investigation for three Kashmiri students arrested by police in different educational institutions in Punjab to National Investigation Agency. Meanwhile, experts on Kashmir's affairs believe that the arrest of Kashmiri students in India and subsequent probe by NIA is an attempt to mislead the international community by portraying Kashmir's freedom struggle as foreign-sponsored movement instead of being indigenous. Commemorations are underway around the globe to mark the centenary of the armistice that ended World War I. World leaders, including US President Donald Trump, Russian President Vladimir Putin, French President Emmanuel Macron, German Chancellor Angela Merkel, and British Prime Minister Theresa May have gathered in France to commemorate the day. In London, Britain's Queen Elizabeth and senior members of the royal family attended a festival of remembrance to commemorate all those who lost their lives in the conflict. In Australia, a ceremony was held at the National War Memorial in Canberra. In New Zealand, a gun salute took place in the capital, Wellington. The third one-day international of three-match series between Pakistan and New Zealand will be played in Dubai today. The series is level 1-1. And that is the end of the news. For more news and analysis, log on to our website radio.gov.pk and also watch live video streaming of our bulletins on the link facebook.com/radio Pakistan News Official.